Hi, welcome to this module on CCPM course, wherein we will discuss about monitoring and control techniques in project management. In the previous module, we have learnt about freezing the scope, schedule, and resource allocation part. Till this point, we have covered four steps of focusing process. The final step in focusing process is all about not being complacent about the performance, but keep monitoring the project for any uncertainties and take necessary corrective actions. So let us do that. Now the question is about what to monitor in a project. Which variable in a project would help us to understand its status better? It is a buffer that we need to focus on to check if the project is on track or off track. But this buffer is very much raw and not useful as such. It should be designed with right indicators to help us understand if the slippage is acceptable or it will impact the project. Thus, we divide the time buffer into three zones: green, yellow, and red. Here we have divided 20 days into 6 in green, 6 in yellow, and 8 in red. Okay, what we are going to do or what information we would be able to get out of this buffer monitoring. When the penetration of a project, it is in green, as we have shown here, penetration in green, it indicates a normal situation and most of the variables are under control. Here notice that the estimated time of completion is 24 days, but original estimation was 20 days. Still fine, because the customer required timeline is 40 days, and if we could finish the project in 24 days, that's good enough. So these slippages are very much normal and it is acceptable. However, what if the penetration is in yellow? It indicates that the project is still under control, however, it may get off track at any moment. Here, the estimated time of completion, it becomes 28 days. Okay, slightly we could sense the delay in the project. What if it is in red? Penetration in red indicates possibility of delay, and hence at this point, the issue has to be escalated to the top management. Notice that the estimated time of completion here is 34 days. Any more slippage will take us close to the project deadline and hence the delay. Hope you had a better understanding of how to use the buffer indicators to monitor and control the project. However, it doesn't end here. Determining the size of the buffer itself is crucial in effective monitoring. For instance, larger green zone leads to the situation wherein the project will seem to be under control even if the key milestones are not achieved. At the same time, a very conservative approach would lead to a situation wherein the project will be very much under control, however, the status report shows situation contrary to the truth. This leads to extreme pressure on the project team. So, now that we know we can monitor the project using buffer zones, there is an important prerequisite to achieve effectiveness, monitoring effectiveness. It is frequent status reporting that brings the best out of monitoring mechanism. Let us understand the effect of frequent status reporting in monitoring. In the Q project, assuming the activity startup delay of almost 5 days, we could notice the penetration in yellow zone. Here the estimated time of completion is 29 days. Let us say we are getting the next status report. Here we get to understand that the project is moving very slow and the penetration is noticed in red zone. Now this is time for top management to intervene and bring back the project to track. Now in the next status report, we could notice that the buffer penetration has retracted to yellow zone, which means there had been some action from top management. Now again, in the next report, the project has still not moved to green zone. So the project manager is expected to be careful not to allow any more slippages. The next status report, the project has retracted very much close to the green zone. Hence, the project is being brought back to control. Here you could notice that estimated time of completion is 28 days. The following status report, you could notice a comfortable situation for the project. because it is very much in green zone. Again, in the next status report, the project slips back to yellow because of some slippages in assembly. However, from the penetration report, we can understand that the slippage is not too severe. Thus, with frequent status reporting and associated buffer penetration, we can understand the exact happenings in the project and thus take necessary corrective action wherever necessary. So far, we have monitored the performance of task in critical path using buffer. However, what if the task in non-critical path slip? How we could control this slippages? How we could monitor this? Here again, we need to use the buffer principle. We need to define similar non-critical path buffers at the point where the non-critical path meets the critical path. It is these buffers that we need to monitor for effective performance. Now let us understand a bit more about these buffers. What we have designed is a linear buffer. Such linear buffers are hardly useful in effective monitoring in realistic situations. That is, when we say linear buffer, it is nothing but we have split the buffer into three equal zones or proportional zones. This is not exactly useful in the realistic situations. Let us go back to our timeline to understand why it is not useful. Let us say, in this project, even on the second day of the project, activity 1 has not started. You could notice a penetration in green zone and an estimated time of completion is 22 days. Good enough. In the next status report, on 4th day also, we find that activity 1 has not started and the penetration is still in green. Thus, the buffer indicator misleads us that the project is going on fine when in reality it had not started at all. So, this model doesn't really help a project manager. More logical answer would be a proportional buffer indicator, a variable proportional buffer indicator. So let us see what it is. Let us define a metric, buffer burn rate, which is equal to the rate of percentage buffer penetration to percentage project completion. It's simple. If 20% of project is over and 20% buffer is consumed, then the project is performing better, right? However, if 20% of project is over and if the project has already consumed 80% of the buffer, then the project is not on track. It is consuming the buffer very fast. Let's understand this with an illustration. Here we'll understand percentage buffer penetration. Again, this term is the ratio of total penetration in days to total buffer size. In our case, let the buffer penetration be 4 days, which is in green zone. Then we get percentage buffer penetration as 20%. That is, total penetration is 4 and total buffer size is 20. So we get 4 by 20 into 100, which is 20%. So we have found the numerator value, that is percentage buffer penetration, to be 20%. Now let us move on to understand percentage project completion. Now to calculate percentage project completion, we need to work out the ratio of number of days of project completed to total project duration. In our case, let the number of days of project completed be 2 days out of total project duration of 20 days. Then percentage project completion is just 10%. So earlier we have found that percentage buffer penetration is 20%, and now we have worked out that percentage project completion is 10%. Thus, buffer burn rate would be 20 by 10, which is equal to 2. That is, more buffer is getting consumed for the current state of project completion, which is not good for the project. You can plot several such points based on buffer penetration and project completion. Always note that a project manager needs to ensure the buffer burn rate to be lesser than 1. If it is equal to 1, then buffer penetration is equivalent to the project completion. Nothing much to worry, but however, there is a possibility of slippage from here. However, if it is less than 1, the project is going on fine. Or if it is greater than 1, then definitely the project is consuming the buffer at a much faster pace. So we'll try to understand about this buffer even more in detail. With our linear buffer model with constant proportion, we can define red, yellow and green zones in the graph itself. Notice that even for 0% project completion, up to 30% buffer consumption is allowed, which is not logical. So we need to define the buffer zones differently. So that is where we use variable proportion model. Here you can notice a much better buffer zoning idea wherein the acceptable penetration are at variable proportion. As the project moves towards completion, we allow the project to consume more buffer, indicating with a bigger green zone and a smaller red zone. This is more logical. Let us understand the flaw in the constant proportion buffer model against the variable proportion model. Comparing the constant proportion and variable proportion graphs, we can understand that variable proportion buffer graph shows a more realistic situation than the other one. Thus, it helps us to monitor the buffer in the foolproof manner. However, there is a catch here. Most of the status reports that we receive are human prepared reports. Unless and until the status reports are transparent enough, even with this monitoring, the project will be doomed to failure. But why do you think someone gives us a wrong status report? It is because of fear of punishment, which again is due to wrong metrics. Again, we come back to the metrics that needs to be designed to ensure proper behavior from a team of individuals. So to summarize, we had a long session of discussions on monitoring and control using buffer charts. So far in this course, we have discussed about CCPM implementation in single project environment. In the next module, let us discuss about the concept of CCPM in a multi-project environment. Catch you there. Thank you.